Hi, I'm Jermaine Van Dyken, MD from Out of the Doldrums. In today's video, we'll be discussing a fascinating aspect of plant science, plant stress and how it can lead to increased health benefits, more specifically, something called xenohormesis. Plants are incredible. They've developed some mechanisms to deal with environmental stressors like drought, high salinity, extreme temperature fluctuations, ultraviolet radiation, insect attacks, and nutrient deficiencies. One of the most intriguing ways that plants respond to stress is by producing phytochemicals. These are secondary metabolites that play a crucial role in their adaptation to changing conditions. But what exactly are phytochemicals and how do they benefit human health? And what on earth is xenohormesis? Let's delve into this fascinating topic. Phytochemicals are a diverse group of compounds synthesized by plants in response to biotic and abiotic stress. Examples of biotic stressors are plants and diseases, and abiotic stressors are things like drought, salinity, heat, cold, and heavy metals. These stressors all stimulate the plant to produce phytochemicals. Phytochemicals are not essential nutrients, but their consumption has been linked to a range of health benefits. For instance, a type of phytochemical called flavonoids, which are present in many fruits and vegetables, have antioxidant properties that protect against oxidative stress and inflammation. Another type of phytochemical called phenolic acids, which are abundant in whole grains and some fruits, have been shown to reduce the risk of cardiovascular disease and some cancers. You may have heard of specific phytochemicals, including curcumin, which is found in turmeric. Curcumin has been shown to have antioxidant and anti-inflammatory properties, as well as the ability to improve brain function and reduce the risk of heart disease. One study published in the Journal of Nutrition and Metabolism found that curcumin supplementation improved insulin sensitivity and reduced markers of inflammation in patients with metabolic syndrome. Another study published in the American Journal of Cardiology found that curcumin can help reduce the risk of heart disease by improving endothelial function. Another well-known phytochemical is resveratrol, which is produced by some plants, including grapes, some berries, peanuts, and Japanese knotweed. Resveratrol has garnered considerable attention in recent years due to its potential health benefits, including anti-inflammatory, anti-cancer, and cardioprotective effects. When grapes are exposed to UV radiation from the sun, they produce resveratrol as a defense mechanism. Some studies suggest that resveratrol activates sirtuins, a class of proteins involved in regulating cellular metabolism, leading to improved glucose homeostasis and improved lifespan in animal models, at least. It's also worth noting that maintaining glucose homeostasis is critical for preventing the development of diabetes. Next up, let's talk about Epigallocatechin gallate, EGCG, a phytochemical found in green tea. EGCG has been shown to have antioxidant and anti-inflammatory properties, as well as the ability to improve brain function and reduce the risk of cancer. Ah, so many good things here. Another concept that is pertinent to the health benefits of phytochemicals is xenohormesis. Yeah, that word again. Xenohormesis is the idea that consumption of plant-derived compounds can activate stress response pathways in humans, leading to beneficial effects on health and longevity. This concept is based on the observation that phytochemicals produced by plants in response to stress can also activate stress response pathways in animals that consume them. For instance, it's been shown that consumption of resveratrol can activate the same stress pathway, known as the sirtuin pathway, in humans as it does in yeast and other organisms, leading to improved health outcomes. So, to summarize, xenohormesis happens when we eat a plant that has been stressed and creates certain phytochemical compounds. When we eat that plant, we benefit from the phytochemicals and our body uses them to activate our own stress response pathways. This is so good for our overall health. Another group of phytochemicals that has received much attention for their health benefits is glucosinolates, which are present in cruciferous vegetables such as broccoli, cabbage, and kale. Glucosinolates are metabolized to isothiocyanates, which have anti-cancer and antimicrobial properties. They're also highly anti-inflammatory. Furthermore, studies have shown that consumption of cruciferous vegetables can improve detoxification pathways. That's how they reduce inflammation. The most famous isothiocyanate from cruciferous vegetables is called sulforaphane. Check out the videos I've made all about sulforaphane. They're linked in the description below. We've talked about some well-known phytochemicals like curcumin and sulforaphane. But guess what? There's more lesser-known ones. For example, the compound apigenin found in parsley, celery, and chamomile has been found to have anti-cancer properties. Quercetin found in onions, apples, and berries has been found to have anti-inflammatory and anti-cancer properties. And anthocyanins found in my personal favorite, blueberries, and blackberries and raspberries too, have been found to have antioxidant properties and may help prevent chronic diseases. Is it too good to be true? It's worth noting that plant stress can also lead to the production of toxic compounds that can harm human health. Here's a good example. Some plants produce cyanogenic glycosides, which can release hydrogen cyanide upon hydrolysis. Two common plants that produce these compounds are cassava and lima beans. So if they're not properly processed before eating, they can cause cyanide poisoning. Yikes. Researchers continue to explore the complex interplay between plant stress, phytochemicals, and human health. Some studies suggest that exposing plants to controlled stressors such as heat or low water availability can lead to an increase in phytochemical production, which can confer health benefits upon consumption. This approach is known as stress-induced xenohormesis and has been demonstrated in a range of plants, including grapes, peanuts, and tomatoes. So yeah, the health benefits of a plant depend on the stressors the plant was exposed to during its development. To this end, one of the most exciting aspects of this research is the potential to develop crops that are tailored to produce higher levels of these beneficial secondary metabolites. This would not only benefit human health, but also improve crop yield and sustainability. For example, researchers are exploring the use of genetic engineering techniques to increase the expression of genes responsible for the production of specific secondary metabolites. This could lead to the development of crops that are more resistant to stressors and have higher levels of phytochemicals. An example of this is the purple tomato. Have you heard of that one? Purple tomatoes have been genetically modified to produce higher levels of anthocyanins, which are antioxidants that give the tomatoes their beautiful purple color. These antioxidants have been linked to a reduced risk of certain diseases, such as cancer and cardiovascular disease. The increased levels of anthocyanins in the tomatoes make them a potentially healthier food option. Another really important point is that understanding the mechanisms behind plant stress-induced health benefits could also lead to the development of new drugs and therapies for human diseases. For example, resveratrol has been studied extensively for its possible potential in treating conditions such as diabetes and Alzheimer's disease. So, to wrap it up, the concept of xenohormesis is a fascinating one. It highlights the interconnectedness between plants and humans and the potential benefits that can arise from this relationship. With continued research, we may be able to unlock the full potential of plant stress-induced secondary metabolites and their impact on human health and well-being. By consuming a varied and colorful diet rich in fruits, vegetables, and whole grains, we can benefit from the phytochemicals produced by plants through xenohormesis. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you want to show us some real support, subscribe. What did you think of this video? Let us know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. Wishing you the best on your health journey. Aloha.